Hi guys, I'm back to do a video comparing hydroxychloroquine to remdesivir, which is another drug that they've just got done studying, and I want to just compare the two. So there's been a big mistake by the World Health Organization when they sent the study to various publications. So the Lancet Medical Journal was rushing to publish the study right away because of the success of this drug, and they accidentally sent the wrong study. They sent a Chinese trial, which by the way, was randomized, double-blinded, placebo-control with 237 patients. The problem with publishing the wrong study, using this drug by the way, there was not an association with statistically significant clinical benefits with this medication. Whoops. So they republished the correct study that they wanted to show, which involved over 1,000 patients. And it was randomized, double-blinded, placebo-controlled trial, but it only really showed a moderate improvement in recovery time from 15 days of recovery to 11 days of recovery. It's like a 30% improvement, but really nothing else. And of course, this drug is not going to be cheap. It's 750% more than the flu vaccine. So you see this in the media. They're really excited. They finally found a drug that is somewhat workable. It's a good start, as they completely ignore the hydroxychloroquine. In fact, the media tends to filter out and showing the studies that don't work or actually make it worse, when in actually they're just really bogus studies. They're based on a survey. It's not a credible study, but unless you read it, you're not going to find that out. And by the way, as a side note, hydroxychloroquine does decrease the risk of thrombosis. And if you haven't seen my video on the relationship between clotting and the COVID-19 virus, check it out. Just another benefit of this drug. However, there is a new study, I'm going to put all these links down below, of a French virologist who tested hydroxychloroquine and an antibiotic that showed that 91.7% of all the patients that were tested for COVID-19 in 10 days did not test positive for the virus. This is incredible. This should be on the front page of the news, not this drug right here. The mortality rate or death rate was 0.5% with no cardiac toxicities. And this is an extremely inexpensive drug. I think it's like a dollar a treatment. Obviously, the drugs that are really cheap don't get a lot of attention. Now, I'm glad you stayed this far because I want to show you an amazing story in Africa related to this drug that I think you'll enjoy.
It's not just the Western world that has the scientific know-how to beat the virus. In Senegal, a laboratory has used its AIDS and Ebola experience to develop a $1 COVID-19 testing kit. Al Jazeera's Nicholas Hawk has more.
Senegal is doing what most countries can't, testing everyone, symptoms or not, entering a health center for the novel coronavirus. It has no shortage of testing kit thanks to this lab at the Institut Pasteur. Researchers are developing a $1 quick diagnostic kit, originally made to test for dengue fever. Patients drop blood or saliva onto the devices and wait for a bloodline to appear, like a pregnancy test, explains researcher Amadou Sall.
There is no need for a highly equipped lab. It's a simple test that can be done anywhere. The idea is to rapidly produce 2 to 4 million kits, not just for us, but for African countries, so that we can detect and isolate patients quickly.
The sick are administered a cheap anti-malarial drug called chloroquine, commonly found in sub-Saharan Africa where malaria is endemic. With only 50 ventilator machines for 16 million people, Senegalese engineers are using a 3D printing machine to produce more. While imported ventilators cost $16,000, this one is just $60. Senegal is counting the cost and it's paying off. More than a month into the outbreak, the small West African nation suffered only 2 deaths, with most patients treated healed. Senegal has the largest rate of recovery in patients infected with the coronavirus in Africa, the third in the world, ahead of countries like the United States and France. And while it has a tiny health budget compared to those countries, it has a wealth of experience in dealing with infectious diseases and outbreaks.
Amazing, isn't it? Inexpensive. Great success rate. Put your comments down below.